स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम बैक। वी आर स्टडिंग द लेसन द फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस लेसन, दैट इज अबाउट द वैक्यूल्स एंड द सेल डिवीजन। फर्स्ट वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द वैक्यूल्स, देन वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द सेल डिवीजन। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट द टॉपिक वैक्यूल्स। सो व्हाट आर द वैक्यूल्स? Vacuoles also cell organelles which are present in the cytoplasm of the cell. You know that various cell organelles which are present in the cell, like all the organelles, so what vacuoles also present in the cytoplasm, and they performs important function in the cell. And we can observe in both the plant cell and animal cell, vacuoles are present and they performs very important function in the cell. So how they are in the nature, where they occur, and what is its function? Let us study now. At first, we'll study about the nature and occurrence. So how they are in their nature? So vacuoles are the sac-like structure. How they are? They are sac-like structure and they are bonded by the single membrane. So how they are bonded by the single membrane? So inside that membrane there is a space, and the space is maybe fluid filled or the solid filled. And its main function is what? Its main function is to store the various substances. So what are the vacuoles? Vacuoles are the fluid filled or solid filled single membrane bounded spaces. So they are kind of storage sacs. Why we have said storage sacs? Because they store the various substances in it. So because of that we have said what? It is a storage sac. It is a sac like structure. It may be filled with the fluid or the solid. And what it does, it helps to store the various substance. The substance is required for the cell to perform the various metabolic activities. Understanding? It is about the its nature and occurrence. So I already have said we can observe both in the animal cell and plant cell vacuoles. So but its size is different in both animal cell and the plant cell, and its position is also different. So let us study one by one. So at first we'll say about in the animal cell. So in animal cell, how it is? It is small in the size and also it is a temporary sac. What we can say is a small in its size and temporary. So what we can say, they store the water, glycogen and the protein. So how it is there? It is a small in the size, and how it is there in its nature? It is a temporary sac and it is filled with the water, proteins, glycogen and the water in the animal cell. And this vacuolar membrane is typically a single membrane and is often associated with the maintenance of the water balance. So what it does, sometime water will be less in the cell, so it helps to balance the water level in the cell. Who helps to balance the water level? So vacuoles helps to balance the water level in the cell. And so how it is there in the plants, how it is there in the animal cell? It is a small in size. And it is not present in the middle, it is present in the side of the nucleus. It is present around the nucleus. So how it is? It's a single membrane, bounded by the single membrane. And what it does, it helps to balance the water level in the cell. And it performs water balancing in the animal cell. So next we'll study about the plant cell. In the plant cell, how it is there? It is a large in its size, it is a distinct and it is a permanent. How it is there? It is a large in its size and it is a permanent sac. Understanding? And what we can in a mature plant cell, if you observe under the microscope, you can observe what? So 90% of place will be occupied by the vacuole. Because of this, what happened? The nucleus will be placed in the side of the cell membrane. So you have observed the plant cell. So in the plant cell diagram, so we can observe there is a vacuole. Vacuole will be in the maximum place, will be occupied the maximum place of the cell, and the nucleus will be side. Otherwise it will be side and it will be near to the cell membrane. But in the animal cell, so nucleus will be at the center position. But in the plant cell, it will be what? Nucleus will be near to the cell membrane because of vacuoles. So what it is? It is pushed near the cell membrane. Understanding? It is about what? A plant cell, and the vacuole is bounded by a membrane called as the tonoplast. So what it is? It is a bonded. Already you know that it is bonded by a membrane. So So that membrane is called the tonoplast, and in the plant cell it is filled with the cell sap. So what the cell sap is containing, it may be containing the water solution, and that is containing the rich, it will be containing the sugar, amino acids, proteins, minerals and metabolic waste which are required for the plant cell. So vacuole is water, it is filled with the cell sap. Then the cell sap, what it will be containing? It will be containing various, so what is containing a solution. That solution will be rich in the sugars, amino acids and proteins, minerals and metabolic waste. So these all are required for the what the plants which will be, what the places which will be stored in the vacuoles. It is about the plant cell. So already we have seen about the animal cell. In the plant cell, so how vacuoles are there, what is its function. So common and generally what we can do is having some functions in the cell. So what it is having the function, see, and what vacuoles helps to maintain the osmotic pressure in the cell. So what it does, so it helps to maintain the osmotic pressure. So that osmotic pressure is very required for the plant to perform the various metabolic activities. So who maintains that? Vacuoles helps to maintain that osmotic pressure in the cell. So next, what you can see, they store the toxic metabolic waste byproducts and the end products of the plant cells. So toxic, they are very harmful. So those will be stored in the vacuoles. So end products of the byproducts are the waste products of the cell. It will be stored in the vacuoles. Understanding? So after that, so they provide turgidity and rigidity to the plant cell. So helps. So in the plant cell, they performs very important function. What they does? They helps to maintain the turgidity level of the rest. It helps to maintain the rigidity level, rigidity of the plant cell. It is about the vacuoles. So what all the things we have studied in the vacuoles? So first we studied about the nature and its occurrence. So how it is there in the plant cell and animal cell, and its function, its occurrence and its nature we have studied. Next we studied about its function. I hope you understood today's concept. So if you have any difficulty regarding today's topic, let me know. Thank you.